My name is Josh Klimovich. I'm one of the assistant principals. On behalf of the staff, the administration, and the students here, we'd like to welcome you to our chamber and orchestra spring concert for this evening. We're proud to show off the hard work of our students and Mr. Kujala. Have a great night. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Klimovich, and welcome everybody to the spring orchestra concert. How's everybody doing tonight? Y'all dried off a little bit. Yeah, wonderful weather we're having here. So we're going to start with an arrangement of a very famous Beatles tune, Eleanor Rigby. Fun fact, usually we don't hear string orchestras playing rock tunes. Whether you can consider this a real rock tune or not, I don't know. But fun fact is that Eleanor Rigby and the Beatles, when they recorded this, it was one of the first times that a string quartet was incorporated with a rock band. First time was a Buddy Holly tune, whose name escapes me right now, but it's fairly rare, but it did happen. Thank you. Next up is music from Titanic, and we're going to play the very famous love song that makes everybody cry. Thank you. For a final piece, and it does look like a short program, does it? We actually had one more which wasn't quite ready for prime time, so I decided to save it for some other time. It's an original composition by Soon-Hee Newbold entitled American Landscape. Thank you very much. We're going to have a brief pause to get these people off the stage, and then the next thing you see, I have no idea what it's going to be, and then we will have the chamber ensemble. So give us a few minutes to get set up, and we'll be right back with you.
Hello. What's going on? So Evan and I are seniors. We are graduating this year, and throughout the years that we've been here, Mr. Gujala has been the director of the orchestra and the chamber ensemble, and he has helped us in so many ways, and he's been such a wonderful teacher and instructor to us, leading the ensemble, obviously. And we wanted to do something to thank him. So I was taking a course this year, and one of the projects that we had to do was to compose a piece. Not necessarily compose it, but make an arrangement. And I thought perhaps one of the best things to do might be an arrangement that was, I don't know, something related to something that we talked about through the time that we'd had here. And you know, I had an idea, and I decided to arrange a duet for viola, me and cello, Evan, of the theme song, probably one of the greatest television dramas of all time, which ran for 9 glorious seasons, with wonderful characters named Perry, Della, Paul, and Hamilton. And of course, I'm talking about the great Perry Mason. And the opening to Perry Mason is actually called Park Avenue Beat by a man named Fred Steiner, and it's awesome. And we decided that we wanted to do an arrangement of it, and we worked on it together, and we decided that we wanted to perform it together for Mr. Kujala, because he has helped us so much in high school.
So as Ben said, we will be playing a short arrangement of the Park Avenue Beat, which is a theme to Perry Mason. We know all the students have gotten to know Mr. Kujala really well, especially the seniors over the 4 years that we've been here, including Ben and I. And we just had a lot of fun putting this together, and we hope that it'll be a nice little gift for Mr. Kujala.
So one last thing, Mr. Kujala, please come out. We can't possibly thank you enough for everything that you've done for us. We really appreciate everything from the, you know, sarcastic little jokes and the little bit of berating here and there. I may have been a problem, but you know, we did this arrangement and we wanted to give you the score and the copy of it because, you know, it's not much, but it's a little something from Evan and I that we worked really hard on, and we hope that you're proud of our efforts.
Thanks, guys. You know, Perry Mason is one of my favorite shows. And it's in black and white. Okay, we'll be out with the rest of the crew momentarily. Okay, we're going to open the next portion of the program with a very famous piece everybody's heard but maybe doesn't know the name of. Eine kleine Nachtmusik, otherwise known as A Little Night Music. We're going to play two of the four movements. The first one is a nice brisk allegro. And the second movement, the romanza, is a slightly more subdued tempo with a lovely flute solo by Kranemer. Thank you. Next up, we're going to do the fourth movement of the Beethoven Symphony No. 2. Thank you. Thank you. Before we perform our last piece, or songs, as some of these students like to call them, I'm going to recognize our seniors who are playing their last concert with us tonight. So I'm going to ask them to stand when I say their name, and if you could hold their applause until they're all standing. To my right is Alex Zhang, who until today I thought was a junior. Seriously, Carly Flanagan is off stage. Carly, front and center. Maggie Wilson, Hannah Kearns, there she is. Brianna Bleeker, Adelinda Amaya, Victoria Rochlak, who I also thought was a junior until a little later today. Ben Solomon, Evan Kazanjian, and Corinna Martin. Give them a round of applause. And our last piece has a little bit of interesting history to it, and since the instigator is sitting right over here, I'm going to put Lucy on the spot, and she's going to say a couple of words about how it came to be.
And I emailed it to Mr. Ujala, and he was like, I don't know if we're gonna play that. And I was like, oh my gosh, please. And then a few weeks later, he pulled it out, and we're playing this now. I'm like, oh my gosh, okay. That's it.
She didn't know I was gonna do that. Thank you, Lucy.
Thank you. So we would like to say a few words to Mr. K to thank him for all that he's done for us. It's been a great last 4 years, and so we wanted to give him a nice gift, and so we put together a few of his favorite things. So one expression that Mr. K always says to us is, turn back up the turnip truck. And so we thought it would be fitting to fill a turnip truck with some of his essentials, at least in the classroom. Like an apple, we have some Snickers, his favorite candy. He even provides hair ties for girls who forget them and they can be necessary. And then the most superior pencil, Ticonderoga, so number two, can't forget that. So yeah, now on to Hannah.
So we're pretty sure that nobody can ever top the cardboard cutouts that you've gotten of Justin Bieber and yourself. But we thought that we did plan a little something pretty good.
Alrighty, so now for the past 3 to 4 years, Mr. K has told us what the proper concert attire is. He tells the boys to wear black bottoms and a white top, and the ladies are to wear all black, you know, cover up. But in Mr. K's words, he tells us to wear black burlap sacks. Here you go, Mr. K.
We just want to thank you for all the... right now? You... you give us a lot of advice. Some of it's, you know, good. Some of it's... But really, we thank you for everything that you've done for us. And...
So Mr. K, I'm not sure if you remember this, but a little bit ago, I told you that you were not allowed to retire or get a new job until I graduate. So just think, in about a month, you're free to go. But in all seriousness, really, like, thank you for making the past 4 years really great. And
yeah, thank you, Mr. K, for everything you've done, from our sips of water at the water fountain to everything you put up with us. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, ladies. And that's a pretty sharp-looking truck. I haven't had a Tonka truck since last century. So anyway, thank you all for coming and braving the weather and the crowds that are infiltrating the school tonight. Really appreciate the support and all the help that you give to the students. And they're the ones that do most of the hard work, so why don't you give them one more round of applause. Thank you, and good night.